Deaths due to COVID-19 continue to rise in the U.S. despite declining infections. As this report tells us, most of the fatalities are among the unvaccinated.
Even as COVID-19 cases and hospitalizations show signs of plateauing in hard-hit pockets of the United States, the still rising death toll from the Omicron variant highlights the trail of loss that follows every virus surge. An average of over 2,300 people, mostly unvaccinated, are dying each day due to the Omicron variant, which is up 30% from a week ago, according to a Reuters tally. That surpasses the height of deaths caused by the more severe Delta variant. As the highly contagious Omicron surged in December and earlier this month, hospital systems from New Jersey to New Mexico buckled under the sheer number of patients. Some brought in for Omicron, others for something else, only to discover they too had the virus. And while cases nationally are down by 12% in the last 7 days, Wafa El-Sadir, a professor of epidemiology and medicine at Columbia University in New York City, warned this does not spell the end of COVID.
I think for many people, there's been the sense of almost an anticipation or a hope that there'll be one day when COVID will be completely gone, that they'll wake up and say, okay, today there's no more COVID than yesterday there was COVID. This is very, very unlikely. It's very unlikely that we're going to be able to eliminate or even eradicate this virus. And therefore, the future, I think, is really all about how do we live with COVID, but also how do we minimize the risk, and particularly for the most vulnerable, how to protect them from COVID and its many complications.
One bright note Tuesday, despite the recent uptick in deaths, according to a new U.S. study, Omicron does appear to result in less severe infections than seen during previous waves, with shorter hospital stays, less need for intensive care, and fewer deaths as a percentage of overall cases. The study said the lower severity is likely related to higher vaccination rates, as well as prior infections providing some immune protection.
Pfizer and BioNTech start clinical trials of a new version of their vaccine, specifically designed to target the Omicron variant. The companies plan to test the immune response generated both as a three-shot regimen in unvaccinated people and as a booster shot. They are also testing a fourth dose of the current vaccine against a fourth dose of the Omicron-based shot. Pfizer said a two-dose regimen of their original jab may not be sufficient to protect against the highly transmissible variant, and that protection against hospitalizations and deaths may be waning. Still, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says a third dose of an mRNA vaccine like Pfizer's has provided 90% protection against hospitalization due to COVID.
It's official. Omicron is now the predominant variant of COVID-19 in the Philippines. That's according to the health department, which says nearly 100% of the samples collected in January contain the highly contagious strain. Both sublineages of Omicron have also been detected in the country. The BA.2, known as the stealth Omicron, has become a predominant sublineage in most regions, while the BA.1 was detected in 8 regions and was found mostly in returning overseas Filipino workers.
Sa ngayon, kailangan natin maipaalala at tandaan ng ating mga kababayan, walang nakitang significant difference sa clinical presentation ang BA.1 at BA.2, at kinakailangan pa rin po ng masusing pag-aaral dahil limitado pa rin naman ang ating mga obserbasyon na nakukuha dito.
The Philippines logged 17,677 new COVID infections Tuesday, the lowest single-day case count since January 7. The health department also reported 79 additional deaths and 33,000 more recoveries. The number of active cases now at 247,000. The COVID risk level in Metro Manila may have been downgraded, but 13 other regions were put in a critical risk classification. These include Bicol, the Cordillera Administrative Region, Western Visayas, and the Davao Region.
Manila's Chinese New Year festivities canceled once again due to the COVID pandemic. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno says dragon dances, street parades, and firecrackers are banned on January 31st and February 1. But Moreno says the occasion can still be celebrated by families in their homes. He's also keeping Chinatown in Manila's Binondo District open to tourists.
Ito ano lang naman, pag-iingat. Pero sa mga bahay-bahay nila, or the family can get together, celebrate, and I hope they will also practice due diligence. But anything, public celebration, large activities is being prohibited. Lalo na yung dragon dance. Kasi talagang ano yun, nakaka-attract ng tao.
A new study shows the Omicron variant can survive on plastic surfaces and human skin longer than any other strain. Japanese researchers found Omicron's survival on plastic could last up to 193 hours or 8 days, while Delta can survive for 115 hours. On human skin, the Delta variant can last for 16 hours. Omicron, on the other hand, lives longer at around 21 hours. But all variants of SARS-CoV-2 will die within 15 seconds of exposure to alcohol-based sanitizers, which highlights the importance of maintaining hygiene.
Yung paraan naman for the virus to reach our systems, the portals of entry, will still be through our hands. So kahit gaano pa kakatagal mabuhay yung virus sa isang surface, for so long as malinis yung kamay natin, wala siyang paraan na tumalon para pumasok sa katawan natin.